What up? It's the Trooper. Today is Monday, October 2nd, and last night I made a decision to not go to the strip. It turned out to be a good decision for me, but my decision on whether to go to the strip or not had no effect on what happened there. As 99.999% of the world knows, there was a shooting. A dude on the 32nd floor of Mandalay Bay shooting into the Route 91 country music festival or whatever. And I happened to be home. I went out to Fremont Street for a very short period just to bring a few hats to some people that were down there. And then I came home. I was really tired from going to the gym and stuff. And so I was this close to being asleep at about 10:30 p.m. And I thought that my phone was off. And if it was off like I thought it was, I would have slept until this morning and realized everything that happened then. But my phone buzzed. It was someone that I don't even know, who I guess follows the vlog, sent me a DM on Instagram. And it was sharing Dan Bilzerian, or Bilzerian, however you say his name. His Instagram story, and he was running saying that someone got shot, and I heard what sounded like helicopters. And then I ended up Googling the news, realizing that this was a real situation, and then I got up and watched it on my laptop on a live news stream from a local station here in Vegas for like 3 hours. My plan was to get up today and do a mail time and add some footage of me going downtown yesterday and the mail time and making a vlog. But instead of doing that, I just wanna say, you know, prayers for Vegas. I really don't know what to say. You know, it's 2017, it's Earth, and it's a horrible tragedy. You know, I don't really know what else to do or say about it, except just recognize that it happened. And, you know, I made a post on Facebook and Twitter because as soon as I got up, I started getting messages and stuff, and I thought about my mom, and, you know, she's gonna wake up and see the news. So I sent a text to my mom saying, just so you know, I'm at home safe. And then I made a post on Facebook and Twitter, just my way of saying that I wasn't there. It was before Facebook put up the crisis page where you can check in and mark yourself safe or whatever. But then I did that, and yeah, I mean, I honestly don't know what else to say about it, except that I really do feel for, I mean, I feel for the people who died. As of this moment, it's 58 and possibly more. And the last number I heard on injured was 515. I just, you know, I really do feel for the people who were killed, and just as much for the people who were injured and the families of the people who were, you know, killed and injured. And I mean, I was watching it live for 3 hours, and there's all these people in Vegas, their families from all over the world, all over the country, all over the world. And it's just, I don't know. I still don't know anything about motive. You know, they've released the guy's name. We know a little bit about him. You know, there were a lot of false reports coming in about shooters at Mirage, shooters at Paris, shooters at, I heard Mirage, Paris, New York, New York. I heard that there were active shooter scenes in all these different places, which all turned out to be false. There were also reports of explosives. The only explosion that went off in Vegas last night was the explosion when they breached the door to the room where the guy was. I don't know. I don't know what else to say. The hashtag Pray for Vegas is about, that pretty much just sums it up. I mean, pray for Vegas, that's it. I just don't even want to do a mail time today. I don't want to do the vlog from yesterday and the mail time today. I just don't even, I don't know. I mean, life has to go on. And, you know, this could have happened anywhere in the world. The fact that it happened in a place where I could have easily been, and a lot of people that I know could have easily been. I don't even know still if I know anyone who was actually at the concert or in the where the shooting took place. I do know people who were locked in the basement at my friend Nojan, Mr. Dorson, was in the basement at Mandalay Bay, was probably a bit terrified because he didn't know. this, you know, before we find out that there's only one shooter, before we find out that that one shooter is dead and that the danger is that, there's a lot of time that goes where we don't know what's going on. So, you know, I feel for Nojan, who was in the basement at Mandalay Bay, and I also have people who watch the vlog who were locked down on the 11th floor of Bally's Hotel, that couldn't even go to their room in Bally's, that stayed in the hallway for hours because no one knew what was going on. No one knew if this was a coordinated attack with several shooters. No one knew anything. And there were all these false reports coming in. Somebody else at Aria was messaging me. I feel for those people who were terrified at the time, because call it whatever you want. If you want to call it domestic terrorism, if you want to call it terrorism, I mean, the thing is that 58 people minimum died, 515 people minimum were injured, but everyone involved was a victim. Everyone involved was a victim. Every person who was at the Mirage, Mandalay Bay, Bellagio, Paris, were a victim of terror at that time. I guess what I'm saying to you is that from my perspective, I feel for all those people. I feel for everyone who was on the Strip last night, mainly the people who were in the concert and the show and the families of those people. And I don't even know. I mean, it's just a crazy thing. So it's unfortunate that one of the characteristics of Earth is that tragedies happen, and sometimes they are natural tragedies such as hurricanes and earthquakes and all sorts of stuff like that. And then sometimes there are man-made tragedies like the one that happened last night in Vegas. So pray for Vegas, and I'll see you next time.